Fine. So there is one part of the section in this chapter which talks about force on a current, right? We have learned that a moving charge will experience a force, right? How much is that? Moving charge experiences a force of magnitude QV cross B, right? Now when I say that current is there, okay, does it mean that charges are moving? Yes or no? Which charge is moving? Positive, negative? Negative charge is moving and positive charge is stationary. Alright? So charge is moving. So if charges experiences a force, then automatically the wire which has the current will experience a force. Isn't it? Now, it is difficult to measure the charge. That is why one of the reasons charge is not the fundamental unit. The current is a fundamental unit. Right? Current is very easy to measure. Okay? Ammeter or galvanometer, whatever it is, you can measure the current very, very accurately. So, for the practical purposes, it is easy for us to deal with current and to find out how much force is there on a current. Right? So, we would ideally like to know the force on a wire that contains a current I. Fine? So we'll try to use this expression itself to derive the force on a straight wire which has a current I. Okay. Suppose there is a wire like this. Current is I. Cross section area is A, number of free charges per unit volume is N, the length of the wire is L, okay, and inside the drift velocity is VD. Okay, if drift velocity is like that, current will be in opposite direction because it is electron, right? Can you get this expression of force in terms of all these things, VD, A, L and N, okay? What else is given is entire thing is in a magnetic field B that is perpendicular to the rod going into the plane. In terms of A, VD, small n, and B and L, get the value of force. The hint is, the total amount of force experienced by the moving charges will be the total force on the wire. What will be Q? Q will be what? Here. Total charge that is moving inside this wire. How much is that? Small n is number of free electrons per unit volume. So how much charge is there inside this wire? Number of electrons will be what? N A into L, right? So total charge will be what? Number of electron into charge of one electron. Getting it? Now what will be their velocities? What is the velocity?
VD.
Not just VD. They will have a random velocity as well as a drift velocity. Because of the random velocity, net force get cancelled off. So we don't need to consider the random velocity. Only systematic velocity will have a net force. Fine. So we'll ignore the random component. We'll say that this entire thing is moving with VD. So charge Q is moving with VD. Right? And this VD is perpendicular to B. So VD cross B is just VD into B. Fine. So the force becomes what? Q, which is N A L E, then V D cross with B, like that. Okay. Which direction the force will be? Tell me. V D cross B, which direction? VD is like this, cross B, so it is downwards. So the force is downwards. Is it correct?
So can you use that?
This is electron. This downward force would have been on the positive charge. On electron, it will be opposite. Fine. This is the force. Getting it? Vd cross B down on a positive charge. It is a negative charge, so it will be up, opposite of that. Fine. These are electrons. Fine. Now, if
sir,
I
can we use the left hand rule also?
You can use sir. This is N E A V D. L cross B written now. What is this? Can you recall? This is I, right? But once you represent it as I, you can't have a vector inside I. So what you do, you drop the direction from V onto length. You make length as a vector. And what is the direction of this length vector? In the direction of current or opposite direction of the electron velocity. Getting it? So if I write this as I L cross B, I'll get the direction of force. Fine. So direction of force is in the direction of length cross product with magnetic field, and length vector is in the direction of current. Just check whether you get the upward force only, L cross B. L is like this, in the direction of current, and B, upwards. Fine. In order to find the cross product, align your right hand towards the first vector, and then fold your hand towards the second vector. Thumb is the direction of cross product. You can't do like this, then you have to fold this way. You have to do like this and like that. Getting it? So this expression is what? Force on a conductor of length L, which is in the magnetic field B. Till now we have been using this. Okay? What if the conductor is like this? How will you find? And magnetic field is going in. How will you consider this? While you analyze this, what you will do? The current is moving like that. This is the current. Is length vector constant? No. Every time length vector changes, here it is in this direction, there it is in that direction, here it is in this direction. So what you will do? You will take small lengths, like DL, DL lengths. If you consider small length, you can treat it as a uniform direction, one direction thing, fine. So you have found out an expression for a straight wire. For a curved wire, you need to integrate. Every DL you have to see which direction the force is, and accordingly you integrate. Okay. Any doubt on this? Nothing? Okay, do this. There is this wire onto which current I is flowing. Magnetic field is inside. This is basically a semicircular wire. This distance is, of course, 2 times the radius, this is the center. Fine. Magnetic field is given as B. Find out the total force on this curved wire. Do this first. You have current like this, okay? The length is L only and current is I, magnetic field is B. Fine?
So, length of the whole thing is L?
No, from here to here. A to B is L and B to C is also L. This is 60 degree. First do this, then we'll go there. Not getting it? Acha, can you see that it's just combination of two straight wires? Find out force independently first on this and then on that. Add it up. Which direction the force will be on AB? Up or down?
Up.
L cross B. Which direction it is? L is down. And then you move towards the B. So it is, it's like this. If you do like this, L, then you have to go towards B, right? L cross then B. So it will be down. Down only, right?
Sir, isn't it after the broken energy? It's not this one.
L cross B, this is length, length vector from A to B. Okay? See, keep it very simple. L cross B. L cross B. Okay? So this is the force on AB. Force on BC will be like this. Getting it? So total force, how will you find? Will this force be equal to this force in magnitude?
Yeah.
They are equal. How much is the magnitude? I L into B. Because length and magnetic field, they are perpendicular to each other. Okay? And you see that this component will get cancelled off from that component. So vertical component get cancelled off. But this component will get added up. Fine. How much is this angle? 30 degrees. You draw a line like this. This will be 30 degrees. Okay. So this is also 30 degrees. So you'll get ILB cos of 30 degrees. Two times of that. One from here, one from there. Fine. So this is the total force on the wire. Getting it? And if wire has mass m, then this force is equal to mass m acceleration. Now try to do this. Consider DL-DL elements. Here DLM. This is DSM. You can assume it to be straight. Which direction the force will be on this DL? On this DL. This is the DL vector. Which direction? It will be inwards, perpendicular,
yeah.
Right, directed towards the center. Fine. So, can you see that this vertical component get cancelled off from another similar element over there? Getting it? Whose force is also like this? So this component will get cancelled off, right? Only component that is left is horizontal one. Getting it? Now let us zoom this. This is the situation. This is dl vector. Fine. And you have a force that is perpendicular to dl like this. You have to take its components along horizontal direction. Some construction like this. This will be equal to 90 minus theta, and this will be equal to theta again, right? So this force value is how much? Let us say this is df. Sorry, this will be df. This will be df cos theta, right? So only df cos theta we have to add. Did you get the point? So because the vertical component df sin theta will get cancelled off. Fine. So df cos theta is the force along x axis. Fine. And df cos theta is what? I dl into b into cos theta. Fine. And now look at here. This is I b into dl cos theta. What is dl cos theta? Dl cos theta is this length. Getting it? So dl cos theta becomes dy. If it is, this is dl hypotenuse, no? This is 90 degrees. So this length is dl cos theta. Fine. So now just imagine here there is a dl. You have to consider this length, this dl here, again this length. Every time you are adding up the vertical lengths. So if you keep on adding vertical lengths, you will become 2r. When you integrate, you keep on adding vertical lengths, the total force will become ib into total vertical length, which is 2r. Getting it? In that case also, how much is this length? First tell me, what is this length? The half of the length. This is 30 degree, this is L, so this is what? L cos 30, so total was 2L cos 30, right? Here also it is IB into 2L cos 30, vertical length. So you take any shape of the wire, you take this also, if you know this distance, which is L, the force, net force on this will be IB into L. Now at times force, magnetic field will be given, like it will be given that magnetic field B is 2 tesla, 1 tesla and whichever direction it is, fine. But many a times magnetic field will not be given directly. Have you calculated magnetic field due to various shape and size? Straight wire, circle, solenoid, toroid, we found magnetic field, right? So that magnetic field which is coming IL cross B or QV into B may not be directly given, and it need not be. You may have to find out using those formulae. Getting it? Alright? But that magnetic field should not be for because of its own current. Are you getting my point? That magnetic field should be external magnetic field. Magnetic field of other current can create a force on the current. Magnetic field due to the second wire or second current can create a force on the first current, like that. But magnetic field due to the first current cannot have a force on the first current itself. It's like you applying force on yourself. There will be equal and opposite force, Newton's third law, and get nullified, become zero. Fine. So next topic is just that. I mean, just a small example is taken, as in two infinite wires are taken like this. Draw these wires. They are placed parallel to each other. Fine. distance between the wires is D. Fine. The current over here is I1 and current over there is I2. Alright. You need to find the force on the L length of this wire. L is the length. Both are infinite though. Should I do it? See, the hint is you have to find magnetic field on this wire due to that wire and then use I across B. How much is the magnetic field due to I1 onto I2? Due to an infinite wire, what is the magnetic field? You guys practice at home, like, or you just throw your books away and then 1 week after you come here class without looking at what is done. Magnetic field is mu naught I1 by 2 pi d. What is the direction of this magnetic field? Onto I2, what is the direction of this magnetic field? I'm asking something. You have to speak up. Tell me, which direction is the magnetic field?
On I2.
Obviously, what I'm asking you for so many now?
Outward.
Huh? What do you think?
Inward.
How?
I want to.
Why are you using this thing? I have already told you, use that curve, this thing. Right hand curl rule. Unnecessary, you're confusing yourself. I don't understand. What is the point of teaching so much if you are still you're using what is confusing you? And what is the point of you coming here? Huh? How many times I told you, put your thumb along the wire and then curl your hand. It is going inside. Magnetic field onto I2 is inside. Goes in. And what is the direction of force on I2 because of this magnetic field? Because of this magnetic field, direction of force. What is the value of force? How will you find the value of force? Magnetic field is this. The force is?
ILB.
No. IL cross B.
Or cross B.
What is the direction of force? Onto I2 because of this magnetic field. Left or right?
Left.
Left. Let's check. L is along the current, so L cross B. So it is this way. So these two currents are attracting each other. I1 is putting a force this way and I2 will be like pulling it that way. So they will be equal and opposite. Neutral third law. Right? So the force will be what? I2 L into B. See, because L and B are perpendicular to each other, L is like this, B into the board. So this is just multiplication of length and magnetic field. This is the magnitude of force. So magnitude of force is mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi D into L. Fine. Now if you increase the length, this length if you increase, the force will increase, right? I am saying this length is infinite. The force will also grow infinite. That has no meaning. So we'll just talk about force per unit length. So F by L is mu naught I1 I2 divided by 2 pi D. Okay? This is the force per unit length, Newton per meter. Newton magnetic dipole moment, galvanometer, see, till you guys do practice at home, all of this is useless. This is you just, if you don't look at it after going home, this will just evaporate. Your coming here is useless if you don't do any problem practice. Okay. I'm just introducing you a concept. Real learning happens when you sit alone in your home practicing problems.